What's up, guys? In this PowerDirector 16 tutorial, we are going to learn how to cover up my face. And I'm literally going to cover up my face with a monkey face. Now, you can also blur face, and I do have a video that shows you how to do that, and I'll have a link that you'll see it'll pop out here. And that'll show you how to blur faces, but you may not want to blur faces. You may want to turn around and put a face on a face. So click on your actual video, and then we're actually going to go to Tools and Motion Tracker. And what we're going to want to do is this square that pops up. This is the motion that we're actually going to track and what we want to keep track of. So normally, I guess you could put that on your nose, on your face. And I would see even make, I would even say make this quite a bit wider. So it covers quite a bit of your head. Really stretch it out kind of like that. Because we're actually going to put the mask inside. Now, once we get set up like that, over here it's going to say track. So now we're actually going to track our face, and it should put a yellow box around our head like that. And now we're tracking ourselves. And it's keeping track of where our head's moving and bebopping around. And that's what's going to keep us where we're going to put our face. Now, when it's done motion tracking, and you'll see it's just about finished here. We can then put our image on top. This can be any image you want. Like I happen to choose a monkey image. And you click the disk and then import media file. So I can go from the hard drive. I can go from the media room. And I've already put the picture in the media room. So I'm just going to go to media room. I'm going to double click that. It's going to load our little monkey face in here. And then it's going to show up here. Now, again, we can set this up a little bit. You know, we can stretch it out and get it where we want it within the video. And we can go pretty large, pretty whatever we want to do there. I guess I should stretch maybe this out a little bit that way. And then when you get it where you want, you say OK. And basically, we're done with a monkey face on her face. Once you hit OK, you come back to this room here, and now we've got our monkey face in our video. If we hit play, you'll actually see how the monkey face is actually staying around the head. And thus, you're ending up hiding the person from anybody knowing. Now, you can do this in videos where maybe you don't want to blur the face. Maybe you'd like to put funny faces in. Maybe you'd like to put other things in. If you want to actually get this more perfect than what that is that you're seeing, like your head pokes out a little bit, or you want to mess with that a little bit more, then what you're actually going to do is you're going to click here on the actual picture of the monkey or whatever picture you use, and then you're going to go to keyframes. Once you're into your keyframes, you can go over here where it says frame by frame, and you can actually adjust it and get it super perfect. You'll probably be in the keyframe section for quite a while. The more you can get it perfect with the tracking, the less you'll have to go into the keyframe section, which is here. And then moving your video ahead by frame is there. So that's actually very, very important. But that's pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. That's how you replace a face over top of somebody if you're trying to hide them. Or maybe you just want to be somebody you're not. Maybe you want to open up a YouTube channel and put some type of mask on your face or something. That would be a good way to do it. At any rate, guys, here's another tutorial for PowerDirector 16. Hope you like it. Thumbs up. Subscribe. Let's hook up. Hit some comments in the bottom. If you'd like me to advertise your actual YouTube channel, let me know. Send me a PM. Have you heard of Peter Gregg? Peter Gregg actually reviews cameras, gives you hints on how to do photography, what's good, what's not, good lenses, bad lenses. I mean, the guy's got it all. He's out of Florida. He's got a little dog he calls Jingles, and literally he's got a Christmas room that runs 24/7. Very easy to listen to, very easy to learn from. If you haven't, you might want to go check out Peter Gregg, and you might want to sub him and learn about cameras. Anyhow, guys, I'll catch you on the next one. Like I said, you want me to actually put you at the end of a tutorial, let me know, send me a private message. And like always, I'll catch you guys on the next one.